Hi everybody on this Saturday afternoon again. God's been really taking me deeper this week. He's been really, really making me look at myself and looking around me at people. And so I've probably withdrew myself a lot from everything around me, because I believe when you do that, you do get closer to the Father in heaven, when you really shut everything out and just get close to him. And he laid on my heart today, well, actually the whole of this week, is trust. If you're a follower of God, do you trust him? Do you trust him with everything you have? Because everything you have, he gave you anyway. Do you trust him with your speech? Do you trust him with your health? Do you trust him with your family? Do you trust him with the decisions that you make daily? Do you trust him on the path that he wants you to walk on? Do you trust him with the choices that he lays on your heart? Do you trust him with every fibre of your being? Because if you trust him, then we need to be all looking at ourselves. We need to be looking deeper at ourselves, because sometimes we get sucked in to the world and start to trust the world and what that can offer to us. We start to puff ourselves up and think to ourselves, you know, I'm better than this one because I've been doing this more than this one, and I've been doing this more than this one. You're nothing without the Father. You're nothing without him. If you're a Christian and you're walking, you are still alive and you're walking. Everything you have, your health, your family, your house, your job, God gave it to you. God gave you those. As on a loan. He gave it to you on a loan. I want to bow my head because I just want to say a little prayer, because I don't want to take control of this situation. I just believe God wants to speak to somebody today. He wants to speak to somebody today. Lord, I pray that you move powerfully, powerfully on somebody today. But it's like I've just said, we are nothing without you, Father. Nothing without you. And we're only something when we are with you. Everything we have is because of you. The breath that we inhale is because of you. Every single thing we own is because of you. All the people that are around us are because of you. The joy in our heart is because of you. And I just want to say thank you, Father, that I will trust you with my life. From now until the day I pass away from this life, I will trust you, Father. And I thank you for all the goodness you've brought in my life. Every peace. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name. Amen. Yes, everything we have is because of God. We should never get a haunty spirit and think that we're better than anybody else, because we're not. We should never look down on somebody and thinking we're better than what they are, because we're not. God came to this earth to show people love and peace and kindness. Not to think that you're better than somebody else. He didn't do that. He came so that we could have life with an abundance of life. And that we have power. We have power to say, you know, in him, not in us, power within him, so that we can stand boldly and with no fear in our hearts when something comes across our path. Because God has got his eye on each and every one of us. And he sees each and every one of our hearts, each and every one of our hearts. And we will not answer to nobody else. But this is what he lays on my heart. I will not answer to nobody else but him. When I die, the way I live my life here, I will not answer to nobody but him. And that is who I seek daily in my life. I don't seek people's approval. If you don't approve of me, then that's up to you. That is up to you. But if you do, that is up to you. I come under the approval of my Father in heaven. And I seek his guidance. And I seek his power and strength and boldness. I seek his, because I know his ways are always the best ways to follow. Because sometimes when you do go to another person for advice or whatever you want to know, unless it's through prayer, we as humans know nothing. We know nothing. Nothing at all. We try. We try to put things right. We try to do, and I said that last time when I was speaking. We try to do it. We try to take things in our own willpower, our own choices. We want to do our own choices. We want to do our own will. That's the word I'm looking for, our own will. We want to do our own will. But in the end, it all comes down to God's will for our lives. And sometimes when people stray away, I know that God's still moving on those people. It's all about your whole trust bringing you to that cross. Excuse me. Bringing your whole self to that cross and laying your whole life at that cross and just giving it to him. Because all what we are is because of pain inside of us. It's because of unforgiveness inside of us. Because God is about love. God loves everyone. He loves everyone. And as Christians, that's what we should be showing. His love. His love. Not ours. Not what we want. His love. That's why we need to trust in him. We need to come to the cross daily and sit at that cross or kneel at that cross, asking for forgiveness and repentance and giving our lives up to him daily, humbling ourselves under the mighty hand of God. Humbling ourselves under the mighty hand of God. Because, like I said at the beginning, we're nothing without him. Everything we have that we think that we own, because sometimes we think we own our kids, we own our property, we own our job, we own our car. That's all alone. It's all on loan. Because that can be taken away in an instant. Like that. So don't claim anything on this life. Because God gave it to you in the first place. He gave it to you. Because he loves you. And he wants to bless you. And each day we should trust in him. And come to that foot of that cross and give our lives and ourselves to him. To him. And trust in him. And him alone. I read something this morning in a book. And sorry about that. I've got a bit of a cough. But I read something in this morning and it really did speak to me. It spoke to me. And it says, permit me to ask this question. In which particular area of your life are you conscious of needing the Spirit to be at work right now? Is it in the anointing to consecrate? Is it in the anointing to consecrate? The anointing to minister? The anointing to save? The anointing to do good? The anointing to heal? Then this is what we should do, because we're nothing without him. Then we take a few moments during the day and let him search and save, wound and heal, strip and clothe, humble and exalt, empty and fill. The art of moving closer to God is always to identify the need and bring it to him in fervent believing prayer. The passage today reminds us that the Spirit provides an unfailing supply of power. We might run out of our resources, but we need to never run out of the divine resources. To those who have no might, God increases strength. And I believe that because I know what I used to be when I was younger. I used to be really fearful and live in anxiety, but he's taken that all away. And if I do feel that now, I walk through it. Whether it's a person, whether it's a place, whether it's whatever I'm doing, I'll walk through it. Because it's not my power by whether it's done. It's by his power. He has the power to sustain us if we trust in him, if we give our lives to him. if we give our all to him. And then once he gives it to us, don't get that haughty attitude or that haughty spirit to think that you're better than somebody else. Because everybody is loved the same. We all have the same chances. We all have the same in God because he loves us all the same. And sometimes I believe it saddens God when he sees these people thinking that they're better than whatever. And that's people who are not Christian, who people who aren't Christian. We need to come to that cross with a humble attitude daily and thank him. Thank him with a grateful heart. A grateful, grateful heart. Because we are nothing without the Father. Nothing at all. But with the Father, we are all things in him who strengthens us. We are all things in him. We are nothing within ourselves. If we trust in him with our whole heart. And he gave me a little scripture. And a lot of people go to church, sit in the churches, but they're living in fear. They're living in fear because God wants the goodness for you. He wants you to have good lives. But if you're not moving out and you're living in fear and anxiety, nothing's going to change in your life. You need to look and seek God daily. Go to his cross, trust in him. Give him your all. Give him your all. Give him everything you own. He owns it anyway. But give it to him daily. Give it, you know, thank him. Thank him daily for it, whatever he's given you. And it's Timothy 2, 1, 7. And it says, for God did not give us a spirit of timidity, but a spirit of power, of love, and self-discipline. He didn't give you a spirit of being fearful. He didn't give you a spirit of fear, to be fearful. He gave you a spirit of power. It says there, a spirit of power, of love, and self-discipline. And that's what we should carry as Christians. And sometimes, when you've been walking that path for a long, 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 long time, we can get comfortable in our little chairs. We can get comfortable. Well, God wants to shake up because, you know, nothing. He wants to show people him, and nothing will get done because it gets done by people. So come out, trust him. Come out. Stand firm. Walk with him because he is your power. Trust in him daily. Walk with him daily. Give him your all and he will show you miracles in your life that you have never, ever experienced. Don't sit in fearful. Don't be fearful. Because God didn't give you a spirit of fear. He didn't. Thank you for watching today. And I just want to say a little prayer at the end. Lord, I just pray that you wake up your people. Wake them up. Because they're not going to know you, are they? They're not going to know you. When we go through our times and troubles and things that are really tough for us, Lord, that's when you really, really, that's when we really, really get to know you. Lord, I pray that you move on people and show them, Father, show them who you are. In Jesus' mighty, powerful, awesome name. Amen, amen, amen. Thank you all for watching. And I pray that God will move on your life and he will show you that he will never leave nor forsake you. Never. And he is your strength. He is the power that you need to seek. Not in people. Him. Seek him daily. Walk with him daily. Trust in him daily. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.